Could you guess what would be the output for this code? Just pause this video and make a try. All right, let's check. First, fourth, third, and second. If your answers are right, congrats, guys, you know what you're doing. If not, let's see what happens under the hood when you execute this piece of code. Hey everyone, welcome back to Zoref Code with another episode of JavaScript. Let's get started. Here we have four function declarations, namely first, second, third, and fourth, and their respective function invocations at the bottom. When we run this code, JavaScript will create a global execution context and wrap this code inside it. Then the memory gets allocated, and then the execution phase gets started. First function will be invoked, and it gets into the call stack. This gives first as output. It will be popped out of the stack once its work is done. When a function is invoked, new execution context gets created. And when the function returns or completes its operation, the execution context of the function is destroyed and garbage collected. All right, second function gets into the call stack, which pulls the setTimeout function. Since setTimeout is part of Web API, the anonymous function inside it will be moved into Web API with the corresponding time here at 0 milliseconds. And then setTimeout and second function will be popped out of the call stack. The third function gets into call stack, which pulls the promise. Again, it's an asynchronous operation, and the anonymous function inside it will be moved into Web API. And then the promise and third will be popped out of the call stack. Fourth function gets invoked and returns fourth as output, and it gets destroyed. Meanwhile, anonymous function from setTimeout goes into task queue, whereas anonymous function from promise gets into job queue. Even loop will be checking these queues, whether it has anything to process. Among the two, job queue has more priority and make its way to call stack. This gives third as output. And then it takes the function from task queue, which gives second as output. Even loop frequently checks whether the call stack is empty or not. If it gets empty, the things inside the queues will be moved to call stack and gets executed.